Welcome, Zaslow Show 2.0. It is a Tuesday, the 17th of January. Good to have you aboard. We've got a lot going on here today, a lot to get to. We'll pack it into a Tuesday show. However you're listening to us, the show is always presented by Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. 800-747-FREE. That's 800-747-3733. If you're dealing with any kind of personal injury from an accident, get an attorney on the phone immediately when you call Anajar and Levine. 800-747-3733. Title sponsor of all things Zaslow Show 2.0. So, we're going to have our pal Israel Gutierrez on the show with us today. We're going to talk a lot. We'll talk Dolphins with him. We'll talk some Heat with him. We are, we're 2 days removed now from the Dolphins losing the wild card game. And, you know, that means we could take a look back to our poll question from yesterday. Our poll question, of course, you go at Zaslow Show. You can hit me up there on Twitter. And this Twitter, again, still nothing from this Elon Musk. I know he's like kind of a lightning rod. A lot of people hate him. Well, I hate him now, too, because of this Twitter fiasco. And I'm not talking about, you know, the blue checkmark stuff or suspending people or what have you. I know a lot of people are beefing with Elon Musk now. But he canceled the third-party Twitter apps. You know, like, I've been using Tweetbot for like 10 years. Tweetbot's such a good Twitter app. So now he shut down the third-party apps with no explanation. Nothing. That's a shit way to treat your consumers. And so now I'm forced to use this regular, the native Twitter app, and it sucks balls, man. Like, I don't know how you guys are using this regular Twitter app. I can't even navigate it. It's weird. And when I'm scrolling on the timeline, like, there's people I don't follow on the timeline, and it's out of order. I don't know how to use it. I hate this native Twitter app. Anyway, you go at Zaslow Show, you can hit me up. I don't even know if I'm getting my mentions. I really don't. Yesterday, the poll question, Zaslow Show 2.0 poll, after sleeping it off, how do we feel about the Miami Dolphins loss on Sunday? You know, I was very angry. I was really pissed off with the way the game ended. I just feel like they didn't give themselves a chance, you know, and the offense stunk the whole game. Very rare. You could score 31 points and the offense stunk. Remember how bad the Dolphins offense was against the Jets in week 18? They had more yards against the Jets than they did in this playoff game. Dolphins offense stunk. But after sleeping it off, how do we feel about the Miami Dolphins loss? And the poll result, you know, the question, the answers, excuse me, were mad at Mike McDaniel, proud of the team, F the Bills. And the winner at 67% of the vote, you guys were proud of the team. 21% said F the Bills. 12% were still mad at Mike McDaniel. So, I mean, at this point, if I had to say, I would go F the Bills. I would be with the 21%. I'd go F the Bills. I'm not, like, mad at Mike McDaniel right now. I'm not still, I would say that I was mad at Mike McDaniel. I mean, he was terrible on Sunday, and that's something he needs to improve on. But, you know, he looked like a rookie coach out there. I'm not still mad at him. I don't even know if I was mad at him in the first place. I was just angry at the whole scenario. So I would go F the Bills, but 67% of the Zaslow Show 2.0 listener, you guys are proud of the team. All right. Hey, however you're listening to the show right now, like, rate, comment, do all that good stuff. Tell all your friends about the show. The show continues to grow every single day, and I appreciate you guys. So we couldn't get the double dip yesterday. The double dip, of course, everybody knows, is when the Dolphins and the Panthers win on the same day. Panthers win yesterday afternoon, setting it up for the Heat to give you the double dip. Normally, it's the other way around, where the Heat will get you the win and the Panthers will blow it. Well, the Panthers got the win yesterday. They're now 21-20-4. They're at Toronto tonight. Very big test. The Maple Leafs are awesome. The Panthers are not. And the Heat, they blew it yesterday afternoon. Martin Luther King Day in Atlanta. The Heat come up short. We'll get to both of those coming up in a moment. But let's start out with last night, man. So, Monday Night Football last night. We have all of our divisional round games. They're all set up now. We got Jacksonville at Kansas City. New York Giants at Philadelphia. That's going to be a banger. Cincinnati at Buffalo. And Dallas at San Francisco. The Cowboys last night, 31-13. They crush, they embarrass the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Was it Tom Brady's final game? That's the big conversation today. Tom Brady was terrible. I mean, he's throwing the ball out there 60 times. The Buccaneers fired Byron Leftwich earlier today. And the conversation is going to be, what's Tom Brady going to do? Is he going to retire? Is he going to continue to play for the Bucs? The come to the Dolphins stuff, it's nonsense. That ship sailed a couple years ago. Get over it. The Dolphins quarterback is Tua Tagovailoa, as Chris Greer, who addressed the media yesterday, said, unless doctors were to say, and they expect him to be cleared, unless doctors were to say that he's not going to be allowed to play football anymore, they fully expect a full recovery, that he'll be the quarterback next year, and that the doctors assured them that these concussions this year does not make him any more or less susceptible to concussions in the future. I mean, I'm not a doctor. That's what they're saying. I believe in science. So not more or less susceptible to concussions in the future. There you have it. But the story from last night's game, well, there are a couple stories. Number one, Tom Brady. Is Tom Brady done? After the game got up to a slow, like it was a terrible game. You had great games this weekend. Cincinnati and Baltimore was great. Jacksonville and the Chargers were great. Giants and Vikings was great. Dolphins, Bills was great. You had great games this weekend. And it was all kind of leading up to a crescendo, right? It was like, Cowboys, Bucks, this is a big one. ESPN gets the marquee Monday night football game, America's team, Dallas Cowboys. Tom Brady, everyone loves watching Brady. And that game was a dud. Matter of fact, it was the worst game of the weekend. Because even 49ers Seattle, the Seahawks led that game at halftime. At least half the game was fun. That game last night was a bore. I bailed on it. I was back and forth, you know, watching my stories. Oh, Monday Night Raw, so good last. That Rhea Ripley, I love her so much. That stare down in the opening segment, Rhea Ripley and Solo Sikoa. Oh my God, I'm marking out hard for that. All right, anyway, and listen, it's still real to me every Saturday under Zaslow Show 2.0. That's the wrestling podcast. Anyway, that game was a dud last night. But the story's gonna be Brady. And what's Brady gonna do? I mean, the game ended, Brady runs off the field, kisses his dad on the mouth, kisses his mom on the mouth. That's something, huh? At his age, still kissing the dad and the mom on the mouth. And, you know, runs off into the dressing, into the locker room. So, at the end of his post-game availability, give this a listen here. And this is the, you know, him kind of saying goodbye, you know, talk to you guys, you know, see you when I see you. This is the part that's going to be dissected. What does Tom Brady mean here?
Yeah, it just feels like the end of the season, so. I just want to say thank you guys for everything this year. I really appreciate all your effort. You know, I know it's hard for you guys too. It's hard for us players to make it through, and you guys got a tough job, and I appreciate all that you guys do to cover us and everyone who watches and the big fan of the sport. We're very grateful for everyone's support, and I love this organization. It's a great place to be, and thank you everybody for welcoming me, all you regulars, and just very grateful for the respect, and hope I gave the same thing back to you guys. So thank you very much.
So is he saying goodbye because this is it? He's retiring, you know, again? Or I don't quite see it that way. I honestly don't think that he knows. And he said there's no timetable on his decision for what's next. I honestly don't think he knows. I think he's going to take some time. I think he's going to see what the Buccaneers do as an organization. Clearly, Brady was not pleased with Leftwich. They fired him today. Hey, Tom, we want you back. So we're going to get rid of Leftwich right away and try and find a better offensive coordinator for you. I truly don't think that Brady knows what he's going to do. I think that was more about thanking the media for being respectful of his personal life. This was a very difficult year for him, of course. And I think that probably goes into his thinking for what he's going to do next year, which is, does he want to end his career, A, on such a sour note, losing the way they did first ever under 500 season? Or I think there's also a part of him that thinks, I'll be another year removed from the personal stuff. I'll be able to focus more on football, on the team, and I'll be able to go out much better than this. I think he's going to be back. I think he's going to be back with Tampa. And I think that right there, that goodbye was about thanking the media for, you know, maybe they knew Maybe they had extra information about his personal life that they decided, yeah, you know what? That's not for print. That's not for everyone else to know. That is a very personal and difficult season for Tom Brady. I think he was thanking the media for being very respectful of a really difficult season for him personally. Because I don't think every media, every team's media would have necessarily been as respectful as he believes that the Tampa media was. You know, you're up there in the Northeast. Maybe if he's even still in New England, are they not digging and printing the personal stuff and, you know, little notes, little nuggets about what's going on with him and now his ex-wife? I don't think that was about him saying goodbye that he's retiring. And if you see it that way, hey, there's certainly a major case to be made. I think that was more about, I appreciate you guys being really respectful. Now, the other story from last night's game, and by the way, I'm glad the Cowboys won. I like when the Cowboys are involved. I like when the Cowboys, I don't think they've been to the NFC title game since the 90s. I think it's more interesting when the Cowboys are involved. I got nothing against Cowboys. Everybody hates Cowboys. Americans. I don't hate the Cowboys at all. I was rooting for the Cowboys yesterday. I'm going to root for them at San Francisco this weekend. It's interesting when the Cowboys are involved. And, you know, it's kind of like the Yankees with me. I like when the Yankees are involved. I don't have any beef with the Yankees. I hate the Red Sox. I hate the Mets, if we're talking New York. I don't have any beef with the Yankees. I'm glad Dallas won last night. It's more interesting when the Cowboys are involved. That's a huge, if Dallas can win this weekend and get to the NFC title game, that's a massive, massive story. America's team. So I like that the Cowboys won yesterday. So here's what happens. So the Cowboys go up 6-0 last night. They missed the extra point. My oldest is like, oh my God, I missed the extra point. Okay. They end up going up 12-0. I saw this on my phone because I wasn't in front of the TV. They go up 12-0. My son goes, did they miss the extra point again? I go, nah, they must have went for two. They must have been chasing. Well, no. Then I went and checked and they missed the extra point again, which is crazy to miss two. Then I see they're up 18-0. Again, I'm kind of in and out of this game. It was a bad game. They're up 18-0. Whoa. Stop the clock. You miss another extra point? Yeah, you did. I can't believe it. And then I see they're up 24-0. Hold up. There is no way he missed a fourth extra point. But he did. You've never seen anything like it. Now he ended up making the fifth. Okay, good for him. 1 for 5 on extra points yesterday. I mean, that's batshit. 4 extra points missed? You shouldn't be missing one. You don't need me to tell you that. And I don't know what you do moving forward. Who knows? Maybe by the time you listen, because you're in the future right now, listen. I'm in the past. No spoilers. You're in the future. Maybe they've released Brett Maher. I don't know. Although, you're not going to release him before you find a replacement. It's going to be a short week for them. You know, I assume their game is Sunday. It's probably Sunday night. It's going to be a short week for them. You bring in a new kicker to kick for you in the divisional round. I don't think you could do that. I think, unfortunately, you got to stick with Maher. What does it mean as far as field goal attempts? They went for a 4th and 4 at one point. I think they were up 24-0 at the time. You would figure you'd go for a field goal there. But they didn't trust him. And you can't be missing extra points. Dak Prescott, well, the quarterbacks, we'll get to the Manning stuff, the Manning cast. Oh, quarterbacks, they can't handle it when the kicker's missing extra points. I felt really bad for this Brett Maher. After the third, because you're watching this guy self, you're watching him implode on a national stage. There's a lot of shame and embarrassment at that point. I know a lot of you listening may be like, oh, who cares? A kicker, he's got one job. You're right. But then it's also like a human being who is imploding in front of everybody. I felt really bad. I felt really bad for him. So I don't think anything's going to come of it. I think he's still going to be the kicker next weekend. But now we got our games. All right, Jacksonville at Kansas City, which I don't see how Jacksonville stays close with them. New York Giants at Philadelphia is going to be awesome. Cincinnati at Buffalo is going to be awesome. Obviously, you got the unfortunate storyline as, Cincinnati's back at the scene of the DeMar Hamlin stuff from a couple weeks ago. And then you got Dallas at San Francisco, which should be great. old school mid-90s NFC Championship style game, Cowboys 49ers. This is going to be a great divisional round weekend. And Super Wild Card weekend was very good. Like I said, every game but two were good. Last night was terrible, and even Seattle, San Francisco, the first half was really good. Super Wild Card weekend was a major success. Very, very good weekend. The Heat yesterday, before we get to our pal Israel Gutierrez. Also, you know what? Before we get to our pal Israel Gutierrez, I want to tell you guys about Doctors On Call 365. If you're not feeling so hot, all right, being sick's the worst. But having to make that appointment and then your doctor can't see you for a couple weeks when you're sick or you need a prescription right now, so inconvenient. What if I told you that Doctors On Call 365 will come to your home and treat you right there? Yeah, that's right. Doctors On Call 365, South Florida's urgent care that comes to you. Broward County, Miami-Dade, Southern Palm Beach as well. If you're not feeling well, you don't have to go to the ER, wait for hours, and then your copay is going to be more then Doctors On Call 365 charges you. Now, Doctors On Call 365 is self-pay, but you got Medicare acceptance on the way. Private insurance acceptance is down the line also. But you're avoiding the crowded ER or urgent care. And like I said, you're going to pay less for Doctors On Call 365 out of pocket than what your copay is going to wind up being after waiting hours at the ER. All right. Now, look, we're not talking mental health situations or sexual health. You can't call up and say, hey, listen, I got a burning sensation, you know where. That, you got to go to your regular doctor for that. But otherwise, you need a COVID test, a strep test, a flu test, IV fluids. You need x-rays or you need blood drawn. You need a prescription filled or refilled. Doctors On Call, 365.com. They're coming to your home that day. 786-577-9302. You get someone on the phone immediately. 786-577-9302. Doctors On Call 365.com. So the Heat last night, or yesterday afternoon, I should say, Panthers had a real good win in the afternoon. The Sabres are a team that's in the mix there with the Panthers chasing a wild card spot. After the Panthers win there yesterday, 4-1, and Bobrovsky was excellent. Boy, Brandon Montour's having a season, huh? But after the Panthers win 4-1, they are now 4 points back. Is it 4 points? I believe they're 4 points back. 4 points back of the number two wild cards, but they have no chance in the division, the Panthers. And I'll tell you why, okay? The Panthers right now, as far as the number three spot in the Atlantic Division, and the number two spot is Toronto, who the Panthers are at tonight. Toronto is 13 points ahead of the Panthers. But the number three spot, Tampa, they're 11 points ahead of the Panthers. And if that's not bad enough, the Lightning also have three games in hand. So potentially, they could be 17 points ahead of the Panthers. The Panthers have no shot at catching the top three in the division. So your sights are set on the wild card. And Pittsburgh right now, who has the second wild card spot, the Panthers are 4 points back of them now, but Pittsburgh's got two games in hand. So it's still a lot to ask for in the wild card. And there's only two spots there available. You're 8 points back of Washington in the wild card. You have a game in hand on Washington. So these games are all huge. The problem is they dug themselves such a big hole that there are really only two spots available for them. And that's the wild card spots, which right now are held by Washington and Pittsburgh. So 4 points back of number two Pittsburgh, but the Penguins have two games in hand. That's a problem, of course. Tonight, the Panthers are at the Maple Leafs, who, like I said, 59 points on the season for the Maple Leafs, second in the Atlantic Division. Tonight's a very big test. Now, tonight would be a good game. Hey, Sasha Barkov, go out there and lead the team to a big road win in Toronto. Huh? How about it? So we'll see. Now, the Heat yesterday afternoon, they lose to Atlanta. And for me, it's kind of like, I don't know. It's a stupid loss yesterday. It's stupid because, not that they lost to Atlanta, you could lose to the Hawks. Lose to the Hawks, like, they're going to lose. I wasn't mad at the Heat game yesterday. They're going to lose road games. And losing at Atlanta, there's no real shame in that. Now, the Heat didn't defend yesterday. Hawks shot almost 60% for the game. So I'm not necessarily frustrated that they lost at the Hawks. You're going to lose road games, but, you know, they come out, they're down by 24 points. And they got to within four late in the fourth quarter, but you never got the ball back with a chance to tie. You never got the ball back in a one-possession game. So the Heat lose 121-113. Tyler Herro, really struggled. Huge game by Jimmy Butler. Hero came back, though. That's a good sign. The Heat are next up tomorrow at New Orleans. Play New Orleans twice this week. Tomorrow at New Orleans and Friday at Dallas, then back home Sunday against New Orleans here. If the Heat would have won yesterday afternoon, they would have become 8-1. Instead, they're 7-2. They would have been 8-1 without Kyle Lowry. You know I was going to be all over that today. We're going to get Israel Gutierrez on in a couple minutes here. We're going to ask. I'm going to tell him I would get rid of Lowry for nothing. We'll see what he says. I would get rid of him for nothing. We'll see what he's hearing about Kyle Lowry and whether or not the Heat are trying to move him. But now 7-2 without Kyle Lowry. And like I said, I'm not getting rid of Kyle Lowry for nothing because of Gabe Vincent. I'm doing it because of Oladipo. And I think the Heat are just better without Lowry. And I'm not sure if Lowry will take to a role coming off the bench where you can lessen his minutes. And I don't know how much of a factor it is with Jimmy where it's like, oh, you know, it's Jimmy's guy. Is he going to be upset if you trade Lowry? The Heat have taken care of Jimmy Butler. I mean, whatever the contract was they gave him, he's going to make $50 million a year real soon. I think Jimmy's just kind of got to kind of eat it on that one if the Heat wind up moving Kyle Lowry. So I'm not really angry about the loss yesterday. You're going to lose road games. And losing a game at Atlanta, it is what it is.